Excuse me, nursery. Could I ask you a question?
Why, yes.
Do you have a will?
Yes, of course.
Do you know where it is right now?
That's my wife's department.
No, honey, you have him at the office. My husband
I don't have him at the office. I told her I didn't take him there.
Excuse me, could I ask you about your family papers?
What?
You know, birth certificates, insurance papers. Can you find them when you need them?
Are you kidding with all this? I can't even find my telephone.
Taxi?
Pardon me, you look like an efficient person.
Oh, thank you. Efficiency is a part of my job.
What about your family papers?
What kind of papers?
Medical records, deeds. Are they organized?
Well, I actually haven't had too much time to think about it, and I don't have any more time now. You'll have to excuse me.
If your important family records are not in good order, you're not alone. To help you organize them, we have developed a new booklet called Your Vital Papers and Where to Find Them. For a free copy, write Vital Papers, AIM, 1909 K Street Northwest, Washington, D.C., 20049.
WIVB TV, Buffalo.
Inflation slowed in the last 2 months of 1978, but not enough to keep the year from finishing up 9% over last year. That staggering figure is the second highest in 3 decades. Only 1974 was higher. We were recovering then from the war in Vietnam and the Arab oil embargo. Last year's prices were led by food and beverages, up 11.6%. Most other areas were not far behind. We're sure these figures will bring cries for price controls on the one side and higher interest rates on the other. The fact is that neither of these old solutions will work. Price controls just delay the effect of inflation. Tight money reduces the expansion of productivity and causes unemployment. The only way to reduce inflation is to improve productivity and eliminate non-productive spending. As it happens, that's one thing the folks in Washington can do. They can provide tax incentives for improved productivity, and they can eliminate the most non-productive of all spending, government spending.
WIVB-TV, Channel 4, Buffalo. Here's the late news summary.
Good morning, everybody. I'm John Beard with the early edition of News 4, Buffalo. In remarks prepared for delivery in Mexico City tonight, President Carter said the people of the United States are fair and decent and are anxious to maintain good relations with their southern neighbor. Carter hosted a formal dinner for President Lopez Portillo after a day of diplomatic talks and a visit to a small farming community southeast of Mexico City. The cost of war has always been high, but it seems to be getting higher all the time. The Pentagon said today the cost of its 52 major weapons programs will climb $22.5 billion during the first 3 months of this year. That's the biggest jump in history. The Pentagon blames most of the increase on inflation, but the rest is blamed on changes in orders or specifications. The president's top inflation fighter, Alfred Kahn, agreed today with small businessmen who have complained about excessive government regulation. Kahn called excessive regulation costly and time-consuming, and says reform was a central plank of Carter's anti-inflation program. Kahn says regulations restricting competition and innovation must be removed, but health and environment must still be protected. The Marine Corps says it is possible that a former prisoner of war who has surfaced in Vietnam could be court-martialed after his return to the U.S., but it declined to speculate on what the charges might be. Corps officials also declined to say whether Robert Garwood of Greensburg, Indiana, might be the same man other POWs have accused of donning a North Vietnamese uniform and joining patrols against U.S. forces. An Oakland, California engineer was pulling into his assigned fifth-floor parking space at his apartment complex when he accidentally pushed his car accelerator instead of the brake pedal. Doctors today described 56-year-old James Barber as a very, very lucky person after his car plunged through a guardrail and did a 5-story backflip to the ground. Barber broke his shoulder and some ribs, but otherwise was unharmed. The Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences honored the nation's musical world tonight in Los Angeles, but comedian Steve Martin stole the show. Martin, who won a Grammy for the Best Comedy Album of the Year, sent the audience into howls of laughter when he walked on stage to make an award presentation without his pants on. A few moments later, he was handed the pants and took time out from the nationally broadcast show to put them on. Billy Joel won both Record of the Year and Song of the Year honors for Just the Way You Are, In Murray's You Needed Me was named the best female pop vocal performance, while Barry Manilow's Copacabana got the best pop male vocal performance Grammy. Album of the year, the soundtrack of the film Saturday Night Fever. The best new artist of the year went to A Taste of Honey. The best rhythm and blues female vocal performance went to Donna Summer for Her Last Dance. Dolly Parton won the best country female vocal performance for Here You Come Again, while Willie Nelson's got the best country male vocal performance for Georgia On My Mind. In sports, Danny Gare and Don Luce combined and scored 4 minutes apart early in the third period to lead the Sabres to a come-from-behind 4-3 victory in Buffalo tonight over the New York Rangers. The win moved the Sabres ahead of the Toronto Maple Leafs in sole possession of second place in the NHL's Adams Division. Buffalo weather, traveler's advisory in effect for tomorrow, occasional snow beginning late tonight. No significant accumulation, however, is expected, low around 5 to 10. It will be blustery on Friday with flurries and local squalls by afternoon, high near 10. Variable cloudiness, very cold with scattered flurries and squalls Friday night and Saturday, low 5 to 10 below, high Saturday only 5 to 10 above. East and northeast winds 10 to 20 miles per hour tonight, becoming northerly 15 to 30 miles per hour Friday with poor visibility at times and blowing snow. The chance of snow increasing to 90% later tonight, and Friday, 50% on Friday night. That's the early edition of News 4 Buffalo. I'm John Beard. Have a nice day.
This has been the late news summary from News 4 Buffalo. WIVB-TV provides accurate television news coverage for Buffalo and the Niagara Frontier. Good morning.
Or Buffalo, New York. Picture and sound portions of our programming are relayed from studio transmitter by STL station KED76.
Some people call me Old Glory. Others call me the Star Spangled Banner. But whatever they call me, I am your flag. The flag of the United States of America. Something's been bothering me, so I thought I might talk it over with you. Because it is about you and me. I remember some time ago, people lined up on both sides of the street to watch the parade. Naturally, I was leading every parade, proudly waving in the breeze. When your daddy saw me coming, he immediately removed his hat and placed it over his left shoulder so that the hand was directly over his heart. Remember? And you. I remember you, standing there straight as a soldier. You didn't have a hat, but you were giving the right salute. Remember little sister? Not to be outdone, she was saluting the same as you, with her right hand over her heart. Remember? Is it a sin to be patriotic anymore? Have you forgotten what I stand for and where I've been? Anzio. Guadalcanal. Korea. Vietnam. Take a look at the memorial honor roll sometime. Of those who never came back to keep this republic free, one nation under God. When you salute me, you are actually saluting them. Happened. I'm still the same old flag. Oh, I have a few more stars since you were a boy. A lot more blood has been shed since those parades of long ago. But now, I don't feel as proud as I used to. When I come down your street, you just stand there with your hands in your pockets. And I may get a small glance, and then you look away. Then I see the children running around and shouting They don't seem to know who I am. I saw one man take his hat off and then look around. He didn't see anybody else with his off, so he quickly put his back on. Well, it won't be long until I'll be coming down your street again. So, when you see me, stand straight. Place your right hand over your heart. And I'll salute you by waving back. And I'll know that you remember.